event of a hazardous material is exposed to the eyes. Shout help to alert your coworkers. Remember, you shouldn't be working alone when handling hazardous materials, and someone should be nearby to help. Immediately make your way over to the Eyewash station, having someone guide you if necessary. Many people's first instinct is to use the sink instead of the Eyewash station because they don't want to make a bad situation worse by potentially flooding the lab. Researchers' safety is the number one priority. Always utilize the Eyewash station in the event of a hazardous material exposure. Activate the Eyewash station by either pulling the handle, pushing the activator, or stepping on the push plate. Holding your eyes wide open, lower them into the streams of water. This part will be uncomfortable, but you must rinse your eyes for at least 15 minutes, constantly moving your eyes around to flush the entire surface. This is a critical moment where much of the eye damage can be reduced or possibly eliminated until medical help arrives. As you are rinsing your eyes, a coworker should call DPS to request medical attention. If you are alone, call DPS after you have fully decontaminated. Even if you've washed for a full 15 minutes, there's potential that further treatment may be needed. Remember, you've been exposed to hazardous materials. You need to be checked out by medical professionals, even if you are not feeling any pain. Always provide a hard copy of the SDS for the chemicals involved in the accident to give to the medical professionals. In the event of hazardous materials exposure, shout help to alert your coworkers. Remember, you shouldn't be working alone when handling hazardous materials, and someone should be nearby to help. As mentioned in the previous eye splash incident, you might need help finding the closest safety shower station. For face splashes, keep your goggles on, your eyes closed, your mouth shut, and decontaminate your face and head. Remove all contaminated clothing. As you are decontaminating your body, a coworker should call DPS to request medical attention. If you're alone, call DPS after you have fully decontaminated. If you are assisting someone using the safety shower, you can help by contacting DPS to alert them of the emergency situation, so medical assistance can be requested if necessary. You can also assist by providing the SDS to medical professionals. This way, the affected individual can focus solely on showering and rinsing for the appropriate amount of time. Hopefully, with the proper PPE and safety measures in place, you won't ever have a need to use the safety shower or Eyewash station in your laboratory. However, even in the safest labs, accidents happen. Be sure to know when to wear safety goggles as opposed to safety glasses. We hope in the event of an emergency that you feel confident to use both the Eyewash and safety shower, two very important safety features of a research laboratory. So remember, 1. Never work alone, and be sure to locate the Eyewash safety shower station before beginning your work. 2. In the event of a face splash or spill, use the Eyewash or safety shower station. 3. Flush for at least 15 minutes. 4. Call DPS. For further information on how to properly use safety showers and Eyewash stations, and for guidance on how to select the appropriate PPE, please refer to the guide sheets on our website at ehs.usc.edu.